Hello everyone, this will be the review of game Fobia, and the key was provided by developer. First problem that I see in this game is that it's lacking Polish font, and I have no idea why it's in Polish, by the way. I didn't check the Polish language. I usually start with English, if it's possible. We're gonna check in a moment. I'm just saying that they are missing fonts. And what is very interesting, someone wrote on the game forum that the game is not priced for Poland. So I have no idea why they add Polish language with missing fonts, and at the same time they don't price the game for Poland. Maybe it's fixed, but it's just messed up situation, very messed up. Okay, let's try with options. I of course switch music, which is at the same time sound on and off, which is bad, should be sliders. The controls are only jumping and moving left and right, so that's it. And graphics, yeah. See, there is nothing about languages. And this is very messed up with resolution. Look. When I'm trying to set resolution, this is how fast it goes. See? This is completely ridiculous. You cannot pick a normal resolution. You cannot just pick the one you want. Why, I don't know why there is two of them. 800, 600. Two of them, two similar. Here you have only one, and those are again doubled. No idea why they are doubled. So I picked the resolution like this one. All right, you have to deal with it. I just couldn't bother to go all the way down because that's just annoying. I'm gonna leave it. It kind of looks okay. So there is no way to pick a language. So the game is in Polish, kinda, but there is pretty much no dialogue in the game, at least for now. And there is no new game also. You can only load game from, like, I guess this is first level. I made it a bit further. So I'm gonna load it from the start because I don't wanna spoil it. I'm only going to show you a little bit of gameplay. Let me just check if it's recording. Yeah, it is recording. So there is this strange grain filter. I don't know if you can switch it off. Probably you can't. Resolution is messed up. The sliders for sound don't exist. And the game is, we could say it's a runner, but you can stop anytime. All you can do is this. You can go left, you can go right, you can jump, or you can stand still. That's it. That's all the difference. All the puzzles in the game are based on that. You either run and jump in the right moment, or you have to stop and let something pass by, or you can go back, right? So there's very, very little buttons. I must say that I do like the graphics. Clearly, I do like the graphics. Let me just set it up again because I want to see the timer. The graphics are okay. I would say it's a notch higher than pixel art. I'm not sure if this is pixel art. It's just hand drawn with limited colors. There's only three colors here, like white, red, and black. Looks very nice, I must say. This graphic style I like. Yeah, okay, this would be the easy one, so you could do this right as an easy one and I die. The problem is that it saves earlier. Usually it doesn't save on the problem, on the obstacle, it saves before it. Sometimes you have to do like two obstacles in a row, and that's very, very annoying. I'm just checking the timer because I don't want to play too long, because I would just spoil all the obstacles I did. I went it like probably one level or something. It's pretty much one long track where you just move from left to right, but it has some sort of checkpoint, and also if you die you start usually before the obstacle, so the game saves your progress, but then you have to repeat the same section multiple times. Now this one is annoying, very annoying. I probably fail it. You have to jump at some point. You don't know when. So I would say that the most of the game is based on proper moment where you have to... Alright, this is gonna come to life, I guess. This is going to kill me. I don't know. Okay. So you have to jump at the proper moment. Most puzzles are about this. Like you have to jump. I know that this is... man, I don't know what it is really. Maybe it was something. Probably nothing, but I'm not sure. I'm just getting paranoid. Okay, so in this case, of course, you have to again jump at the right moment. You do it too soon, it's bad, right? What can I do about it? I could move it like there. Should I? I think I should move it here, and then it stays up. Like this. Yeah. Kind of like in Trine, I would say. with the boxes. So that's how we do it. I'm just gonna go a little bit further, and probably if I start dying on one of the obstacles, I will stop. So the whole difficulty comes from this. Can I move it? No. The whole difficulty comes from this perfect timing of jumps. And to be honest, this is one of the most annoying things in gaming. I really hate platformers, I really hate skill-based games, and I really hate games that just give you one option. So this is everything I hate, but at the same time, it's very consistent in what it's doing. If you like exactly this, if you like platformers where you have to perfectly time your moves and there's only one way to overcome every obstacle, then you will like it, because it's doing it correctly. It's just doing one gimmick, that is this perfect jump. Like here, this is very clearly seen. You have to do like jump, jump. Oh, see, I already got hit. I already got hit by the spikes. So I have to try again, maybe again. What was I trying to say? I have to kind of jump earlier or later. So most obstacles are based on this. You have to jump, but not yet. Or you have to jump already, but you didn't, and you're dead. So yeah, like I jump. Oh, Jesus, God. Again, badly. So annoying. So I personally get annoyed because I cannot use any physics, any options. I cannot like take a box and stop it or something, or use a skill, or maybe take some damage but still progress. I have to do it perfectly. And at some point, I'm just furious about it. I cannot progress. It's too hard for me at some point. Some of those are just too hard. And they don't give me satisfaction. If I do it, I will barely do it. I will do it because I tried 50 times and I eventually did it. And it doesn't give me any satisfaction. I like when I can think my way to winning, not click or jump my way to win. It doesn't give me any satisfaction. But some people like exactly that. Some people like hard, challenging platformers. There is physics, but there isn't much physics. It's not like Trine. I just played Trine a lot, so I replayed a little bit of Trine 1 and Trine 3. So I know that there the physics are done really nice, not to mention the graphics are awesome. But here the graphics are okay, the graphics are passable. They are very interesting for what it is. It's a very small studio. I heard something, it's just two people and they made the game. So they could have gone into this disgusting pixel art area, but they didn't. They did it in a way of minimalistic hand-drawn 2D graphics, and it's actually pretty good. I would say the graphics would be like 8 out of 10, but the whole game just annoys me. Like, I made it, right? I'm not satisfied now. I'm not. I'm like, well, okay, if I was to finish the game for whatever reason, if I was like, I don't know, if I had just this game and nothing to do, I'm like, okay, I'm just gonna do it, maybe. You know, I'm gonna push for it and maybe eventually make it there. Then I would probably just push for it because I would have nothing else to do, no choice. But if I have to choose between this game and something else, I just take something else. If I have this and Dead Cells, I just play Dead Cells. Makes more sense to me. Alright, this can be done. By the way, I failed this one a lot. I'm gonna try to show you the next one because it's very annoying. I think there's like two of them, or very similar ones. Alright, no, it's the other one actually. Yeah, this one is also hard. It's not the end. After you do this section, you have to do one more, which also has to be done. Oh, this one I'm gonna fail. This is the perfect jumping nightmare. You mess it up, you have to start over from the ball. You have to do the ball again and then do the jumping again. It looks easy, but it's not. I failed here like 20 times and it just annoyed me. Every time I played it, I was like, I'm gonna stop. I'm done. Just annoying. I don't want to try again. I don't want to win by trying multiple times. Yeah, this is gonna kill me, of course. I wasn't aware you can jump over it. I think I let it activate and then I jumped on top of it when it was swinging. Yeah, so maybe there is two solutions for this one. I guess there is two solutions for this one, actually. That's a novelty. Like this one is again one solution. You have to do this. No, not this. You have to make the wolf come into the net. And yeah, there's actually two solutions for this one. you can jump on top of this block, which I made it. I also once kind of jumped over it, but you can also not activate it. So the problem is it doesn't save before the obstacle. It saves before two obstacles. So you have to do two in a row perfectly. Like this one has to be done perfectly. You go somewhere right, you don't know where, because there is no indication that there is a wolf coming. So to some, you have to learn. Once you reach this point, you instantly turn left. You have to learn it. Every piece of puzzle you have to learn, which is very annoying. You just have to die and then try again and then master this one pixel when there is the moment of a perfect jump. And if you fail, you fail. You just have to start over. It just gets very, very boring and annoying. Even though the graphics are cool. So clearly not a game for me. It works for what it is. I have to admit it. Absolutely. If you wanted a platformer that is hard and that you're gonna die and repeat sections, that's the game. That's exactly what it is. But I personally have no fun with this. I'm just, you know, trying barely. Yeah, it's gonna break. I think you have to jump a few times, then it goes over me. And I stopped somewhere in the next section where it was even worse. Okay, that's the similar one that before. Of course, everything that can do damage to you instantly kills you. There is no HP bar. One failure and it's over. I think I'm gonna stop on the next one. I don't know what was the next one. Maybe I was stuck on the next one. I'm not sure. They say it's short, but it's not that short if you're just gonna fail. What is it? Did I play it? Maybe? Yeah, I did. Because that was easy, so I did. I got stuck somewhere. And then I just gave up after another 20 attempts. Yeah, I think that was the section when I gave up. It's completely ridiculous. Right. So I forget how to do it. Let me just think about it. I think you have to do two perfect jumps and then stop. And then I don't know. Because you have to relearn it. See, you have to go all that section for no reason. This section for no reason. Which already did. And now you have to do something perfectly. You don't know what. You don't know when to jump. Maybe now. Maybe no. I actually jumped the second time, but I messed up. I think it's two jumps, stop, and then run. But it's at this point I stopped. Because I just couldn't take it mentally. You know, I could try and maybe make it after like 100 attempts. I just am not patient enough for this. I'm patient for games if you have to grind, if you have to try different strategies, if you can, you know, like Dark Souls. You can fail many times, but you can try different build, you can go and grind, you can try different approach, you can use a summon. Here, no, you have to do it perfectly. You have to do those two jumps and stop and jump or something, or maybe other sequence, absolutely perfectly, or else you have to start over. And the game punishes you for failing with this whole repeated section. It's kind of like some games have very long cutscenes that you cannot stop. And yeah, I died again. You cannot sprint. You cannot do any other move, any special move, nothing. You just fail multiple times. I've tried twice. Yeah, I'm going to try twice. And I'm done, really. Because there's no point. There's just no point. You can say I suck. Of course I do. I don't like those games, probably because I suck at them. But I never played games because I wanted to be awesome at them. I just wanted to enjoy the game what it is. I can enjoy the graphics, but I don't enjoy repeating the same section. Yeah. Why? I did it right. Even if I do it right, I will then kill... Well, they will kill me. And that was some bug, by the way. Even if I do it perfectly, then the next part would kill me because there is one more. And then you have to actually see how it's done. Because figuring it out is like testing a code when you have no numbers. You have to try every combination like here. You have to try a little bit earlier, no, that I'm still dead. A little bit further, okay, I did this one, but the next kills me. Okay, maybe I should stop my... Oh, I died. And there it goes. It's trial and error. It's trial and error simulator, I would say. And it just annoys me. There is no fun in that. For me, at least. Some people might like it. Some people might master it and be satisfied. But that's not me. I'm trying. Jump. No. Why? Why I died? Where am I supposed to jump? Maybe I'll jump when I see it. Let's try it. when I see the thing, I will jump. Maybe it should trigger me, like, oh, there is something coming, I jump now. I wonder where it gets me. Can you do it on reaction? I think you can't. You have to know. You have to know that something will break and then you have to jump at this particular pixel. Now, no, no. If I see it, if I do it on reaction, I die anyway. So we probably have to do something like this, two jumps quickly. But I can't do it. I just can't do it. Sorry. This is harder than Dark Souls for me. And there's nothing I can do about it. I can just sit here for an hour and keep trying, but I wouldn't be satisfied. I would be like, damn, I could have played something else. I could have played like entire Dead Cells run and actually reached some progress. Here, no. I'm just gonna fail. See, this is gonna kill me. No. What am I supposed to do with this? Now. See, this is the problem. I tried to do it last time the same way. So there is no way you can do this after the third one is activated. You cannot run from it because it's gonna chase you and kill you. So I see no solution for that. Even if you do the first time part perfectly, I just know no solution for the third element. I still can't do this one. I'm guessing it's two jumps, but no, I did exactly same thing in my mind that last time. I just jumped a little bit after I saw the object coming. I jumped slightly closer to the stairs so that I can do the two jumps, just like the last time, but it was probably one pixel, not enough. And I failed. And I still don't know how to do the last one. If you watch a walkthrough of it, you would know, probably. Yeah, I died. Okay, I'm done. I'm done, guys. I'm done with this. I just don't want to waste time on this game. It's just too annoying for me. So I was probably here. Yeah, I think I wonder if it's the same section. What if I load here? Is this the same section or is it before? It's probably before. Yeah, it's before. Right? So you cannot probably... Can you continue? How do you do it? I don't know. Let's go to menu and then continue. Is this gonna put me at the end? Or before? So I just lost progress, right? I would have to do it again to the point with this swinging object and then keep trying to do this one obstacle. At this point, this game killed me. I'm just done with it. All right, so I think you should fix the font, add languages, because it should have default English and then Polish with proper font if you have to. Well, if you want to sell it in Poland, you should price it in Poland. You should give it a price on Steam. I guess it was a problem. Maybe it's fixed. You should add the font. I don't know what the language is naturally in. Is it English game? I don't know. Hard to say. I would prefer to choose a language, not just be given language with broken font. Option, this is ridiculous. You need sliders for music and sound separately because the music is annoying and then you see you can't hear anything in the game because you have to switch off everything. Then there is no music, but there is sound. It's still switched off. It's annoying. You should just have two sliders. Yeah, that's the buttons use, almost nothing. And if you go back, what was the graphics? There is no graphics. By the way, there is no graphics here. Awesome. That's awesome. Have to go to menu. There is the graphics. So fix this. So it moves normally with mouse wheel. It's not like my mouse wheel is broken. It's this game, just stupid. What is this? Is this about frame rate? Like one is 30 frames, the other is 60. It's not there, right? Fix it, please. Full screen, yeah, full screen works, and it works in OBS, so that's a plus. How much would I give for it? Okay, guys, I'm gonna give it 5 because. It does the jumping correctly, it does the challenge and the difficulty correctly if somebody is looking exactly for it. So people who like hard platformers will like it, because that's exactly for them. I don't, which is just my personal opinion, this is just because I don't like the genre. Not that I don't like completely all the platformers, because I played game with platforming elements and I was absolutely okay with them. I actually finished lately Death's Gambit in one night. It had some platforming as well, and I finished the whole game in one night, no problem. I finished Salt and Sanctuary, I finished Hollow Knight with easy ending, and I finished Dead Cells. No, I didn't finish Dead Cells. I played Dead Cells. This one is harder, just for the sake of it. So, super hard jumping for the sake of super hard jumping. It has broken options and font, which is annoying. Very annoying. And it's supposedly short. I don't know, because I just keep failing. So for me, the game is endless because I cannot finish it. But I didn't play it long. I mean, all my attempts took, let's just check, all my attempts took 54 minutes overall. So I just did it to second save point. I don't know how many there are. So hard to say how long it would take you. If you can do this obstacle, you can probably just follow and probably finish the game in rather short time. But I can't tell you how long it is. I have no idea. It's definitely very annoying and hard. So, as much as the game really annoys me and I hate it for what it is, I cannot use this as a lever in the review. Just say, oh, I don't like it, so it sucks. No, it's doing this thing that some people like correctly, but I don't like it. I just don't like the idea that I have to perfectly make a jump, and that's the whole idea for the game. You just have to not use your brain and use physics that are quite okay in this game, to be honest. Kind of like First Train, sort of. You have, of course, less options, but the physics work correctly. The problem is that there is only one solution for everything. Well, maybe sometimes there is two. Like, you can not trigger something and maybe trigger it and maybe kind of defeat the obstacle differently, like barely. But many times you just fail. So most cases it's one solution, and most cases it's just timed jumping. Sometimes you just have to stop or go back, but usually it's just timed jumps. Absolutely something I hate the most. Like, this is the worst part of Salt and Sanctuary, the worst part of Hollow Knight. If the game is based only on this, I will never buy it, because it just annoys me. That's no fun for me. But yeah, there is some people who like it. So if you like those particular games, you might like it. You might find it challenging. You might have some fun with it. The graphics are good, actually. The technical side lies, well, somewhere in the gutter. It's just everything is kind of broken. The font is broken. The choice of resolution is broken. And the sliders are broken. So everything is just below standard. For graphics, I would actually give 8 out of 10, because it's really interesting. For the complexity of the game, 2 out of 10, right? Because there is just, you jump or you don't, that's it. So too simple. I prefer if there is options like in Metroidvania, or if you have at least a couple of ways to overcome an obstacle. Like, use objects, use some, I don't know, grappling hook, whatever, to make it more interesting. And it's super annoying. And I just don't like it. I mean, if it's for casual gamers, you will never finish the game. If it's for hardcore gamers, it would still have to have those fixed, and probably have to be longer. Because if you assume that someone can finish this game, like one go or two, three attempts, then you should make it longer. Because, well, they would just burn through it and be done with the game. Probably you can do it in 2 hours. I don't know, but maybe if you never fail, you probably can just keep going. I don't know how long it is, but at this point, you would probably finish the game rather fast. So I would just give it a neutral score, 5 out of 10. I personally didn't like it, but there is some market for those games. So if you are into this, you might like it. But I would say grab it on sale. I don't know even if it has a price. You know what? I will check. I will now check if it has a price, because I'm actually in Poland. So let's check it. Okay, Fobia game shop. Let's see. Let's look at the price. Well, yeah, it is priced now. It is priced. So it wasn't priced. It wasn't priced, now it is. But yeah, it's too expensive, by the way. Guys, it's $5. It's supposed to be short, so I wouldn't say it's worth $5. For $5 you can have Resident 3 or Tomb Raider. So no, sorry. You can have Payday 2 for $5. So it's not $5 game, clearly. It's $1 game. Yeah, so that's fixed, I guess. But still, you have to fix the font, right? If you are selling the game in Poland, then fix the font or give me English. I can speak English, or at least barely. I'm trying. But why is it in Polish with no font? I didn't pick the language. I want to pick the language. Where is the language? Why is it in Polish? Is it a Polish game? I don't know. I don't think so. If it was a Polish game, yeah. It says it has 5 languages, right? 8, actually. It says 8 languages. But how do you pick them? How do you choose a language? It has 8 languages. It's messed up. I would like to pick a language here in the options. I would like if the graphic options were present in the game. And I want sliders, and I want normal choice of resolution, not this. What is it? A torture? I don't know. I don't get it. It's a torture device, you know, to make you waste your time and be annoyed. Yeah, the game is very, very effective in making me annoyed. I'm annoyed by the lack of font. I'm annoyed by the options. I'm annoyed by the gameplay. I'm annoyed by the price. So, okay, guys, that would be it. I was ranting a bit, but whatever. A 5 out of 10, that's a Fobia game. A bit overpriced, very hard and annoying 2D platformer game. I guess it's just a platformer game. So that will be it from me, and I will see you guys in the next review.